Let's take a quiz on the topics that we've covered till now. First question. A delivers a horse to B for trial for 8 days. It was agreed that sale would be completed if the horse was found suitable for B's purpose. The horse died on the 3rd day without any fault of either party. It was held that the contract was A completed, B to be completed, C void, D illegal. What happened here was A delivered horse to B for trial for 8 days, and in those 8 days B will see if the horse suits his needs or not. So what happened was on the 3rd day itself the horse died. So now in this case, what would be the status of the contract, position of the contract? Would it be considered to be completed, or it was yet to be completed, or it becomes void, or it becomes illegal? In this case, the contract becomes void. Now, why does it become void? It becomes void because the subject matter has got destroyed. Before the contract was supposed to be finalized, the subject matter has got destroyed. The horse has died. So how can you complete the contract? The contract was about selling the horse after 8 days. And before those 8 days elapsed, the horse died. So now there can be no contract because the subject matter is no longer in existence. Impossibility of performance. Void is the answer. Second, a contract for sale of goods to be delivered at a future date shall be dash even if the seller has got the goods in present possession. The contract for sale to be delivered at a future date. There's a sale of goods and these goods are to be delivered at a future date shall be dash even if the seller has got the goods in present possession. Such a contract would be valid. Now, why is such a contract valid? This contract is valid because goods are existing at the time of the contract. It is merely that the delivery has to be at a future date. Now, delivery is not that important for the sale of contract. What is important is transfer of ownership. So, if there is a sale of contract, or rather contract of sale, that means the ownership has transferred. Now, delivery happens at a future date, that is immaterial. Okay, so contract will remain valid even though the seller has possession. Now, if the delivery has to be done at a future date, that means for those days seller will be in the possession, but still the contract is valid. Next, dash means an act involving the selection and earmarking or separation of goods with the intention of using the goods in performance of contract of sale. A. Appropriation of goods. B. Ascertainment of goods. D. Transfer of goods. D. None. Selecting the goods or earmarking, that is marking them, or separating the goods, separately identifying them. What is this called? This is called ascertainment. This is called appropriation. This is called transfer, or none of the above. The answer is appropriation. We've already studied when the goods are separately, when they are separated from the bulk, when they are earmarked, meaning marked, they are specifically marked so as to separate them from the rest of the goods. This implies appropriation. There was a contract to supply waste coal and ash for the next 6 months. As and when the ash was generated from the seller's factory and the buyer paid the lump sum price for the next 6 months in advance. When does the property in the goods pass to the buyer? A. After the lapse of 6 months period. B. At the time of entering onto the contract. C. At the time of paying advance money. D. As and when factory discharges waste. Now there's a contract between two persons. One is the buyer, the other is the seller. Now seller has a factory which generates waste. Now buyer purchases this waste from the seller, and what is he doing is he's giving the advance for the next 6 months. Whatever waste in the next 6 months will be generated will have to be given to this buyer. So now when would the buyer become the owner of the waste in that factory? When does he become the owner? He becomes owner when the waste is generated. As and when the waste would be generated, he will become the owner of that particular batch of waste. Now, you know, if you carefully observe here, you'll find that the waste here is a future product, future good. It is not in existence as yet. It will come into existence on a future date. And for future date, I mean, for future goods, the property passes as and when they are manufactured or produced, as and when they come into existence. So when the future ash is coming into existence, the ownership will keep on getting transferred. So as and when the ash is generated, the ownership will keep on getting transferred. So the answer is as and when the factory discharges waste. Next. Reservation of right to disposal is available for which kind of goods? A. Specific. B. Existing goods. C. Unascertained goods. D. All of these. It is available only for specific goods. Okay, so that's the answer. Next. When does property of the specific goods in a deliverable state pass? Property of specific goods in deliverable state. A. When payment is made. B. When possession is transferred. C. When contract is made. D. When notice is given to the buyer. Passing of property is not concerned with payment. Passing of property is not concerned with possession. It can either be when contract is made or when the notice is given to the buyer. So out of the two, the answer is when the contract is made. Now why this is the answer? Because D option would have been only when the goods were not in the deliverable state. So the seller would be required to put the goods into deliverable state and then give the notice to the buyer. Once the notice is given, the property would transfer. But we are told that these goods are already in the deliverable state. So the property will get transferred immediately when the contract is made. A sells certain goods to B after the contract of sale, but before the goods were delivered to B. The goods were taken by the government for its own use. Here the seller is A, B, B, C, both, D, none. A sold goods to B, and after this, the goods were taken by the government before they could be delivered to B. So now, who has sold the goods to the government? Is it A or is it B? Please understand that A has already sold the goods to B, so the ownership has transferred to B. So it will be B who will sell the goods to government. You may say that there was no delivery to B. The goods were yet to be delivered and A delivered the goods to government in the meantime. But please understand that sale has got nothing to do with delivery. Sale only means ownership. And when it is said that A sells goods to B, that means A has transferred the ownership to B. Only the delivery is remaining. So when the goods are taken by the government, it will be assumed that B has sold the goods to the government. So B becomes the seller. Okay. Next question. A gives a gold chain to B on sale or return basis and B gives it to C on sale or return basis. C loses the gold chain. Who shall bear the loss? A the real owner, B, C, D, none of the above. Now A has given a gold chain on sale or approval basis to B. B in turn has given it on sale or approval basis to C. Now C loses the gold chain. Who shall bear the loss? The person who shall bear the loss is B. Because you should understand here that the first transaction is between A and B, which is of sale or sale on approval basis. But we are not told if B has approved the goods or no. However, B has done something to suggest that he has accepted. He has given the goods to C on sale on approval basis. That means B has accepted the goods. That means ownership has transferred from A to B. Now B is the owner. So now from A, the risk passes to B because ownership has passed from A to B. And there is a sale on approval basis to C. Though C has the possession of the goods, he is not the owner of the goods as yet. He has not given his approval as yet. So who is the owner? B is the owner. He has the risk. So who bears the risk? It's B. Okay. Next. Passing of title or transfer of property constitutes the most important element to decide the legal rights and liabilities of A. Seller only, B. Buyer only, C. Both seller and buyer, D. None of the above. Passing of title and transfer of property constitutes the most important element to decide the legal rights between of only the buyer, of only the seller, of both or none. Of both, obviously. Okay. Next. In a sale of specific or ascertained goods, the property in the goods passes to the buyer when A, when the parties intended to pass, B, when the price is paid, C, when the goods are delivered, D, all of the above. In specific or ascertained goods, the property in the goods passes to the buyer when the parties intend it to pass. When they want the ownership to transfer from seller to the buyer, it is between them to decide.